Hello everyone, I'm Mark, and you're watching Living Well, Uintah Basin, where success is defined by you. On Beyond the Couch, we meet up with Olympian Amanda Beard at the Uintah Recreation Center as she motivates some of our great swimming athletes here in Vernal. On Dish by Dish, we had so much fun having Tyza Jackson on the show. We invite her back to make another great dish. And on Your Way, we all have our hobbies and passions that keep our minds active. And today we go down to the Rock Academy to show why music is so powerful for the mind and spirit. We've got a great show in store for you. Come with us.
Living Well, Uintah Basin, presented by Ashley Regional Medical Center. Living Well, Beyond the Couch.
Well, welcome everyone to the show. With me, world famous Amanda Beard.
World famous, that's
pretty
nice.
You are world famous.
Thank you.
Well, 1996, I'm 21 years old. And also,
me too,
you're 21, right? You're 14 then, right?
Yeah.
And that was your first Olympics, and also you're a household name.
Yeah, it's kind of weird being 14. You're usually focused on high school and prom and, you know, trying to pass algebra. And now I'm throwing in trying to balance media and going on, you know, just different talk shows and training and traveling all over the world. So very different childhood.
Was it scary?
No, it wasn't scary, especially because I was just so young and naive. I kind of just went through it, just, you know, la, 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 la. But it gets to be one of those things where you're like, I don't want to do another interview. I want to just go hang out with my high school friends at the mall. You know, when you're that age, your priorities are very different.
You don't have a hoopla or whatever.
Yeah.
Just leave me alone.
Exactly.
I just want to be a teenager, right?
Exactly.
Do you think that helped you? I mean, you're 14 years old. You're on the world stage. I mean, this is the Olympics. I don't know how many people watch, but very, very high.
A couple,
I mean, the weight of the moment, was it more?
I think it helped being 14. Yeah. In 1996, just because I knew the Olympics were a very big deal, I just didn't know to what degree they were. You know, how many people were watching and all the cameras in front of my face and stuff, I just kind of like, oh hey, how's it going? Instead of realizing that there are people behind those cameras watching. Yeah. So I was just very oblivious to things, and it helped me kind of go into it very stress-free and really kind of try to enjoy an Olympic experience.
Sure, so 14 years old, what did you win? I don't even know.
Oh gosh,
200-meter breaststroke.
Okay, so I won a gold in the relay.
Golden relay.
And silvers in both the 100 and 200 breaststroke.
Oh my gosh. So three medals, your first time. Did you bring your medals with you today?
I brought one.
Okay, we're going to have a look at those later. Yeah, I'm going to bite it to see if it's real gold. But then you go on and your decoration list of trophies is so long that you can't even...
I don't know.
Yeah, right. I'm reading it, like, and I'm scrolling on my phone, like, when are we going to get to the bottom of this?
Yeah.
So you think 14 years old, then you started a modeling career when you're 16, right?
And tried.
And multiple Olympics, a very decorated swimmer, happily ever after, right?
Yes and no. I mean, I would love to say that everything is just so fantastic and wonderful, but I think the reality of life for anybody is that life is a roller coaster. So you have these really high moments. So you have these wonderful moments where you're standing on an award podium at Olympics, and then you go back to reality and you're going to school. And I struggled with school a lot. School was very difficult for me. And I went through a huge growth spurt after the 96 Olympics. So then I struggled with my swimming a lot. So there were a lot of ups and downs in my career. I would like to say that there were more ups and downs, but it probably leveled out for the most part, but it's a fun journey now in my life. I'm married, I have two kids, and it is, you know, kind of a happy ever after story for me now, looking back.
Right. You know, so much right now, teenage girls, they struggle with self-image, self-worth, regardless of their stage in life, whether they're the last person that, you know, gets to the finish line or the first, they have this feeling of, I'm not good enough. How do we share the message that, you know, you are.
Yeah, well, I think it's not just females. I think females are better at expressing their emotions than men.
Yeah, that's true. we were talking about that earlier, right?
So, but I think men deal with the exact same things that we're doing. We just deal with it in very different ways. But the one thing that I love to do is when I go to events where I get to hang out with a lot of, you know, young athletes is tell them my story, tell them the things that I've gone through, let them know that, hey, everything is, you don't wake up and like there's a rainbow like shining outside and the bird lands on your shoulder and you know, you wake up, you might feel awful, you might be sick, you might be dealing with some family issues or a boyfriend issue or a girlfriend issue. As you get older, you're dealing with even different things, financial issues and jobs and all this hectic stuff. And so you want to learn how to cope with these things and deal with these things in a healthy way. And you know, for me, sports was always a really good way for me to kind of go into the pool, drown out the sounds, swim, relieve all that stress. But then it also can be a stress. So it's finding that happy balance, which is really difficult and it takes a lot of trial and error to do. And my favorite thing is just to hang out with kids and kind of maybe connect on a level of, hey, what are we going through? I've been through it all.
Right, yeah, you talk about your career, looking forward to Rio, right?
Maybe,
right?
Yeah.
Who knows, Dana Torres, right, in 2012.
Yeah.
I mean, so you've got the young guard and now you're kind of in the mentoring stage, right?
What? I try to take, with the younger athletes in the swimming world, nobody wants to be preached at, you know, they don't want me to like come after them and tell them how to do it, especially teenagers. It's more so being,
what, dude,
I know,
know what you're talking
I'll
about.
Find out with my kids
right.
later
you
on.
You only have a 5-year-old, I got a 15-year-old, trust me, it gets worse.
There you go. Yeah. So, but you know, I'd like to be more of the like open ears for them and just voice to them, hey, like if you want to talk about anything, like totally confidential or whatever you're going through and I can share with you my stories that I've gone through, I'm here for you. Just let them know that I'm that person that they can go to if need be. Otherwise, they're gonna do the exact opposite of what I try to tell them.
Sure.
Just like trying to be a mom.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, and isn't it sometimes example, being the first one in, last one out, you know?
Yeah.
You know, taking seriously what coaches are telling you.
I mean,
you can still be coached right now in your phase of your career, right?
Oh, definitely.
Right,
yeah.
So show them by example. So, okay, so I have some questions for you.
Okay.
Yeah, these are
the hardball questions,
yeah,
okay.
What's the weirdest question anyone's ever asked you? Oh, geez. Hopefully it's not on my list.
Uh-oh. Well, I've been asked out a couple of times.
Ooh,
and
we're not gonna do that here.
Good. My husband doesn't appreciate that. No, I mean, it's I've been asked just silly questions by little kids, like what toothpaste do you use? And, you know, like who's your favorite cartoon character and stuff like that. Yeah. Just,
who is?
My favorite, I like watching Phineas and Ferb, but my son does not watch it with me.
Yeah. No, so. He doesn't watch it?
No, so I'll have to watch it by myself.
Time down to the couch, great question. Okay, so first question, onion rings or donuts?
Donuts.
Donuts, really? Really, I kind of saw you as an onion ring person.
No, I'm more of a sweet tooth.
Do they do fry sauce in Seattle?
No.
Oh, that's a Utah thing. We're going to get you some fry sauce before you leave.
Okay.
Lochte or Phelps?
Oh no, that's so hard.
Actually, I knew I was going to give him that one.
Sorry, Ryan, but I'll go with Phelps.
Yeah, and they're not going to watch this. Maybe they will. We'll
Ryan,
post it on your
Ryan's
blog.
So carefree, he won't even care.
He won't even care. Yeah. All right, high heels or flip-flops?
Ooh, flip-flops.
Flip-flops for sure. Day at the beach or day of training?
Day at the beach.
Day at the beach.
I like these questions, though.
Yeah.
They're good.
Do you like these?
Yeah.
Well, I wrote them down. Modeling or swimming?
Swimming.
Really?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Well, the swimming opened up the modeling career, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's fun. You like get to pretend you're someone that you're not when you're modeling stuff. But swimming, like I don't know. I like to like work hard. I like working out. And I like doing like more rough and tough stuff.
Right. What's cooler, doing this VTV interview or having your own Wikipedia page?
Doing this interview.
Of course. I mean, this is great. Okay.
This moved to the top of my list.
Yeah. Gold medal or motherhood?
Oh, motherhood.
Really?
Yeah.
That's
really?
That's the coolest answer I've ever heard in a real
interview.
I would
throw those things in the trash can for my kids. Oh my goodness, yeah.
Favorite sport besides swimming?
Football.
Football. Really? Favorite team?
Niners.
Oh yeah, the Niners. Kaepernick with his flexing and all that stuff. Nah. I was hoping you were going to say the Broncos because that's, you know.
I like Peyton Manning a lot.
Yeah.
And I live in Seattle. I should be a Seahawk fan, but.
Yeah.
Sorry.
All right. Well, I want to thank you for coming, doing this interview with us.
No problem.
It was probably the most enjoyable one I've had. But Amanda Beard with us, world famous athlete, mother, model, author, and a hero. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
What do you expect from your healthcare? A physician you can trust. An up-to-date facility with a friendly staff. Compassionate nurses. Healthcare professionals who will do their very best every day to keep you and your family healthy. At Ashley Regional Medical Center, this is our mission because this is our community and our hospital.
Warriors Warehouse has the preventative and natural products you need to improve your overall health. Nutritional supplements for maximum performance? We've got that too. And if you're looking for the best variety of gluten-free food, the search is over. We also cater to the needs of our customers by providing individualized diet and supplement plans, skincare, and friendly professional service. We have the education and experience to answer your questions and give you first-class assistance backed by our pharmacy-certified Dr. Lewis. Let us show you why we're your number one source for health products.
Living well, dish by dish.
I've got Tyja Bullock on the show with us again today. Tyja, welcome. We've had her before and she just does such a great job, we wanted to have her back.
Thank you.
Go ahead and tell us what you're making for us today.
Okay, so I'm gonna be making roasted apricots with honey today. It's just a really nice recipe that you can keep on hand. It's fast, it's easy, it's light, it's really fresh. You can use any fruit that's in season and apricots happen to be, so we're gonna go with apricots today.
Perfect. Great dish for this time of year.
Yeah.
All right.
So it's super simple. All you really need is, you know, a few apricots. Depending on how many you want to make, how big of a dish you want to make, you know, obviously you may need more. I'm just going to use 4 or 5. About 1/4 cup of honey, some ginger, some cinnamon, and then some Belgian almond thins. You can also use amaretti cookies. Really any crispy, crunchy kind of cookie. That's all you really need. So.
Okay. And these cookies are easy to find.
We were talking earlier,
you can even just get those at Smith's.
Yeah, yeah. And amaretti cookies are nice. They're suspiciously gluten-free. I'm not 100% on that, but they are made with an almond base and an almond flour, so.
Perfect, so for those that have a food allergy, it's a great way to go. Just slice them in half. Do you want me to, I'll get this knife and start cutting them.
Perfect.
A couple others for you.
Yeah, so you're just gonna slice them in half and pit them.
Okay.
And then just lay them in your dish, cut sides up.
So this is a dessert, but it could also be even just a snack.
Yeah.
I mean, it really, really you could use it for anything. And right now I know a lot of people, you know, they've got apricots on their trees. A lot of people have apricots coming out of their ears right now.
Yeah.
So it's a great time to try to get your hands on some.
And this recipe is really versatile too. You can add, I'm doing ginger and cinnamon, but you can use cardamom, you can use a little bit of lavender to really spice it up however you want to.
Okay.
Pumpkin pie spice is kind of nice on it too. Just gives it a little bit of a different flavor. So once you've done that, you're just gonna take your 1/4 cup of honey and pop it in the microwave for just a second.
I'll pop it in for you.
So you're just gonna drizzle that on top of your apricots.
Well, the nice thing about the honey is it's a natural sugar, so you're not adding, you know, all the bad sugars you could be adding to it, you know.
And then your spices.
Okay. That's probably much of it you want.
Yep. It's all to taste. It's nice. You really can't go wrong
here. That was cinnamon you just did.
Yep, that was cinnamon.
And ginger.
And ginger.
I wouldn't have thought of mixing cinnamon and ginger, but that would be good, I bet. And then these are?
And then these are our
the
little crunchy cookies.
Okay.
So you just crush them. And you can use as many or as few as you want. And I just kind of like break them up a little bit more as I'm sprinkling them on top.
Okay, perfect. So you're gonna sprinkle the cookies on top and then
and
we're
then
gonna bake it.
Yeah.
Okay, all right. So we've actually got finished, what they'll look like finished. They actually look delicious.
And the cookies softens up, so it's not really, they don't stay crunchy. You can add more once it's done baking if you like the crunch to it.
Okay, and then you were saying earlier you can add.
Yeah, it's really nice paired with like vanilla bean ice cream or homemade whipped cream. That's what my kids really like. Just whip up some cream while it's baking and there you go.
Perfect. Well, I love this idea because like we said earlier, you know, we've got lots of apricots available to you, especially this time of year. It's light, like you said, so it's not a big, heavy. I'm sure it's not got a lot of extra calories, so
it's just light and fresh.
Yeah,
and
yeah, so you're not eating a lot of calories with it. Great for after dinner, snack, whatever you want to do. So, perfect. Well, we really appreciate coming on and showing us this recipe.
My pleasure.
Again, she's going to have it on our show, so we'll make sure we get you a copy of it. And Tasia, thanks again.
Thank you.
Living Well Health and Wellness Tip, brought to you by Warriors Warehouse.
Adiponectin is a hormone in the body that controls fat metabolism. So having high levels of adiponectin are essential for effective fat burning effect and weight loss.
Natural ways of keeping your adiponectin levels healthy are to exercise regularly, lose weight, have a diet high in fiber, nuts, seeds, and fish oil. Come see us at Warriors Warehouse, 1060 West Market Drive, Suite 1, right behind McDonald's and Smith.
Living Well, your way.
I'm here at the Rock Academy, and I'm really excited to be talking to Brad Litton. He is the owner here, correct? Mm-hmm. Brad, I think a lot of times when we talk about living well, people think of just diet and exercise. And in reality, there's a whole lot more to living well. I consider living well a balanced part of life. And so music is a really important part of keeping that balance in life. Tell us a little bit about why music is such an important part of everybody's lives.
Well, music is everywhere. I mean, if you think about it, you hear music everywhere you go. It's in the store when you're shopping. It's on TV shows. It's in the movies. Could you imagine watching a movie with no music?
No music.
I mean, try watching Star Wars with no, So music is everywhere. It's a huge part of everybody's life, even if you don't realize it. So one of the cool things about that is here at the Rock Academy, we do lessons. We teach people how to do music and how to make it a bigger part of their lives so that they can get more fulfillment from that. And it's awesome because there are so many benefits to doing music, from developing your mind further, to physical coordination, to discipline and personal responsibility, all the things that you learn doing that. But all in all, it's just fun, and that's what we focus on.
Yeah. Well, and you brought up, the mental aspect of it. I think sometimes we think that with extracurricular, a lot of times you think of like sports with the kids or mm-hmm. things like that, but you don't realize how important it is for them to tap into that other side, the creativity or the, mm-hmm. And it also relates, I think, a lot to like their academics. There's a lot of proof that the music helps with academics and all around.
Yeah, it really does. In fact, there have been studies done, I was actually just talking about this with someone, where they did some studies and found out that when you're studying for a test or something like that, you got something going on, it's best to not do that in long cram sessions, right? Mm-hmm. It's best to do it in intervals. But in between those intervals, you have to keep your mind stimulated somehow. And it's best to stimulate another part of your mind. So they found that people who, in between those intervals, will do music mm-hmm. and play music for 20 minutes or half an hour, they actually retain the information that they're studying better and they do better on tests. And it helps develop the rational part of their brain, the creative part of their brain, and it just amplifies everything so that they do better academically, especially.
Sure. Well, and I think another really important aspect is, I think it's a great outlet for kids, and adults. I know even like when I was growing up, I played the piano mm-hmm. and I would come home from school sometimes, and when I'd have a kind of a bad day, stressful day, the first thing I'd do is go down to the piano and I would just pound it out, and then I was all better,
Yeah.
And so I think it's a really good positive outlet for not only kids, but great for adults too. Would you agree with that?
Yeah, it definitely is. I mean, we have actually quite a few adult students here who find that same thing.
Yeah.
I mean, because music is music and it's fun.
Yeah.
And we all have the kind of songs that we like to hear and get us excited and stuff like that. And so I find that fun when it's adults because I grew up listening to classic rock and
sure.
you know stuff like that. So we get to do a lot more of that stuff with the adults, and so it's a lot of fun. But it's the same for everybody, no matter what the song is or what style of music it is. You know, everybody gets that fulfillment, that enrichment from playing music and having sure. a lot of fun with it.
Sure. Well, speaking of fun, we brought the fun in. So let's talk a little bit about what you do down here at the Rock Academy. You guys do group lessons. Now that's a lot of fun. Tell us a little bit about that. I mean, I know you get how many kids in a group session?
We had one yesterday that had 9 kids in it.
Wow.
And it's a lot of fun.
So they just all come together and all ages and mm-hmm. and just jam together.
Yeah, but pretty quick we're going to be jumping into playing their favorite songs and getting them doing stuff together, and it's going to be a lot of fun. I found that the more people that we have in a class, the more dynamic and exciting the environment is.
Sure.
And we have more fun as teachers, they have more fun as students. And it really helps even pull people who are kind of in their shell still, kind of
sure.
pulls them out.
Them out.
Because it's a good environment. We, you know, everybody's on the same team. We have each other's back, you know, and we're just there to have fun and make music. And so it's a ton of fun. We do a lot of cool stuff like that. Just because it's so much more fun to play with other people.
Sure.
And to have that interaction with one another.
Sure.
So we're working on that so that we can do it with everything. But we do quite a few different things. I mean, we've got, especially for the guitar, we do a lot of group classes, but we actually have new classes starting up.
So lots of fun things down here, it sounds like.
Yeah,
I want to get to watching your jam session. I want to kind of wrap this up a little bit, but tell us, you've got guitar, you teach ukulele, mm-hmm. piano.
Voice, bass, drums. I think that's it.
So you cover quite a bit of
ground, yeah.
Perfect.
And it's a lot of fun. So we can help anybody out. So if anybody wants to come down, then what we'll do is we'll get you set up for a free lesson, and we'll get you in here, we'll go over your goals, we'll see what we can do that's going to help you out the best, and then we'll get you going.
Perfect. Well, if you want more information, Brad Litton at the Rock Academy is who you want to call, and like I said, it's just a great way to balance life out and find a hobby that you might enjoy. So Brad, thank you so much for talking with us, and we're gonna go watch you jam for a little bit.
Okay. Sounds great, thank you.
So Andy here is an instructor, and you're also a student, a high school student as well. One of the things that Brad and I talked about is how, you know, music really relates not only academically, but it also can help when, you know, you're having a bad day, it's a great outlet or whatever. Tell us a little bit about how that applies to you.
Well, a lot of the times, life and schoolwork can really weigh down your shoulders, and it can really make you stressed and just exhausted. So when you have something to work on, that exercises your mind, and it stimulates the entire brain, and it just gives you something to think about other than all those other worries. Then it really lets out all those emotions, and it lets you relax for a second. Like Brad said earlier, when you switch back and forth, it helps you retain information. And when you're studying, sometimes it can be really, really boring to study schoolwork. So then when you can go back and forth between something that you find boring and then music, which is really cool, then it kind of makes both things better.
That's great. Well, and what a better job than being able to come and do this. I mean, you can't find a better job in this town, right?
No, you can't.
Well, we appreciate you talking to us a little bit today about that. So Haley's a student down here at the Rock Academy. And Haley, how long have you been coming here?
About 4 years.
4 years. And you said when you first started, you were taking private lessons, and now you're taking group. So you kind of seem like you're a little bit of a shy person. How has group helped? Has it helped pull you out of that shell and helped you with your confidence?
Yes, it's helped me a lot, because when you're playing in a group, you kind of have to put yourself out there a little more, and it just helped me gain confidence too. And people.
Sure. And you've probably met some really great friends through it and have found like a really great community of, you know, a great group of friends. That's got to be a big help as well.
Yeah, a lot of support.
One thing that I love about down here is you guys have like an honor code, you guys have signed that you're going to keep your grades up, you're no drugs, no alcohol, things like that. So it's probably great to surround yourself with people, you know, trying to accomplish those same goals and just have a great outlet through that music.
Yeah, it's helped me a lot.
That's perfect. Well, I appreciate you taking just a minute to talk to us a little bit about it.
Well, we did.
Thanks so much for watching today's show. And remember, it's you, the people of the basin, who make it possible. If you have an idea for an upcoming episode, we'd love to hear from you. Contact us here at VTV Channel 6 or like us on Facebook. And until next time, live well and stay healthy, Uintah Basin.